Welcome YouTube family and friends. Alejandro checking in. First of all, let me give a shout out to all my new subscribers, my old subscribers, people that I've met on the streets. Man, everybody's been cool and giving me good feedback about the content and the excursions I've been doing. And again, I'm continuing to bring more footage from around the country, you know, more excursions, more information and more content. So let's go ahead and jump right in. As everybody knows, it is Super Bowl week down in Sosua. This is probably one of the best times to come down here. A lot of tourists are down here. A lot of businesses opening up. Everybody's gearing up. Since it is the high season, this is kind of like the pinnacle of the year. This kind of kicks off all the festivities and all the parties for the new year. So Super Bowl is definitely a great time to be down here. Actually, this will be my third time here for Super Bowl. My first year for Super Bowl was actually 2 years ago for the Atlanta Falcons and the Patriots Super Bowl. And at that time, I had only I was only planning to be here for about 2 to 3 days because I was going to go back right back home to Atlanta right after the end of the game. But as we know, the Falcons gave up a 28-3 lead in the fourth quarter, and that game kind of altered my life. Like, literally, like I said, I called back home, talked to my sister, my family, friends. Man, the city was hurting. And you know, to have a championship that was so close not come to fruition, you know, it's just something that, you know, you can't explain. So, you know, everybody was, again, aghast and like awestruck and like, how could we have let this happen? But you know, in sports, things happen for a reason. And you know, because of that happening, I turned my 3-day weekend into a month and a half staycation, so to speak. I needed some therapy. Like I said, I didn't want to go back and deal with the city and the talks of, oh man, how did y'all do this and how did y'all do that? So I was just like, well, you know what? I'm going to stay. And like I said, after about a month and a half, I felt pretty good. And that's when I decided to go back to the States. So again, I tell everybody that story is something that led to me actually making the plunge and moving down here, is because at that point in time, it showed me that I could work and you know, still generate income when I was down here. Because before I would never think, oh, I would be able to stay here and work consistently, because I was thinking, oh, there'd be too many distractions, too many parties, too many drinking and all that other stuff. But during that month and a half time frame, I was actually able to focus. And so from that point forward, it put the, you know, the seed in my brain that, you know what, you can come down here for an extended amount of time. And so again, it's almost been 2 years to that point in time that I decided to move down here. Like I said, I've been down here for a year for the most part, and it's been good. Like I said, I've had some bumpy bumps in the road, so to speak, you know, with starting a business and things of that nature. But again, experience is the best teacher. So, you know, with that, I take it for what it is. You learn and you grow, and basically you come out on top and better, you know, the next time around. So for this week, again, the Super Bowl week, we got a lot of parties going on. I know there's always the get together at Flip Flop. Envy, I think they're doing like a full 4-day event, opening up a new club. And again, they're gonna have a daytime pool party. And again, they're gonna be showing the game at their location, and I think they have a buffet. I actually bought a ticket to go there last year, but I didn't make it to the party because I was on the beach watching it, and then I ended up going to a hotel on the strip to finish watching the second half, so I didn't even make it. But my cousin was in town at the time, a couple of friends were in town, and they all, you know, ended up going there. So, you know, that's an option you can go to. Also, there's the Oasis in Puerto Plata. You know, International Skrilla, another expat, you know, who stays down here. I think they're doing a big like concert for like halftime there. Again, they're gonna have food, entertainment, drinks, the whole nine. And again, I've been out there, you know, a couple times before, and I enjoyed myself. So that's definitely, you know, another option you can go to. Again, there's gonna be an array of bars, hotels, like I said, private villa parties, people throwing all type of parties. So I mean, you can just go down the line and take a pick. Pretty much you can't go wrong anywhere, because the party's always going to be going on. So again, Super Bowl week, for those, you know, who are here, again, salute everybody, be safe, You know, don't drink too much, don't get too crazy and too wild. I know it's a joyous occasion, but you know, at the end of the day, you want to make sure that you're safe. And again, everybody's respecting everybody, so you know, everybody can make it back home. For those of you who haven't got your passport yet, what are you waiting on? Like I said, this is January, almost February. Again, I like the new year because that's when we all can reflect on what happened in the last year in terms of, you know, reaching our goals and accomplishments. You know, whether or not it's health goals or whether it's financial goals or whether it's personal goals or relationship goals, we can always reflect, you know, at the beginning of the year and see, you know, is this something that I need to change, or is there things that I want to attain this year that I wasn't able to attain, you know, in the previous year? But I don't really look at it in terms of year to year. I actually look at it on a day-to-day, week-to-week basis, because every day is a new day to grow, every day is a new day to learn, every day is a new step you can take. It's just a matter of just taking that next step. So for all of you that have any, you know, goals and aspirations, like I said, in terms of traveling, in terms of, you know, like I said, health goals, in terms of, you know, just educating yourself, like I said, the best time to start, they say, is yesterday. The best time to start, the second best time to start, is today. So again, don't delay, man. Everybody go get your passport if you can, even if you're not traveling here. I mean, if you've never been outside your area code or been outside of your own neighborhood, I mean, you won't see the world until you start seeing other people and experiencing other cultures. Again, it did nothing but change my life. I mean, this has probably been the happiest I've ever been in my life, but it was just something I had to do for myself. So again, I always encourage others to take that plunge also. Again, coming forward for the new year, again, I got a lot of good things coming. Of course, the excursions are still gonna be there. I might have my weight loss journeys, I've started those, and so I'm actively videotaping those, so I have that coming. And then I have a digital dose series that'll be coming up. So definitely, if you see me in the streets, shout me out. Like I said, man, I'm very approachable, very cool to lay back. So, man, and everybody be safe. Until the next one. Alejandro, I'm out.